back on the van build. Is this the best Starlink flat roof mount for your camper van? Well, today we are installing and reviewing the StarV flat roof mount. I'm also going to be installing this little beast, which is the StarV mount power solution to give you a reliable power source for your Starlink in your camper van. I'll also show you what our current setup was and why I think it was sh. What was the problem with our previous setup? We had our Starlink Mini mounted to the front dash. I'll show you. Some Velcro on the back. Boom. Here. And this was a problem because one, it used to rattle around. Two, signal was inconsistent. If you watch the Arctic trip, you will have seen that driving up, we had great signal, but actually when we were up there, we had to position the van to get signal. We didn't get it whilst we were in motion. The only bonus is that it was inside the van and kept nice and safe, because my fear of putting it on the roof was always, will it get robbed? To power it, I installed a cigarette port there. It worked. It wasn't perfect. It wasn't consistent. That was the problem with the old setup. So the new setup is what we're going to be installing today. And this should give us off-grid, reliable, consistent, and secure Starlink broadband. Let's go have a look at what we're installing. Into the garage. And those of you that watched the last build, in fact this build, will have seen how messy my workshop was. Well, there has been some improvements in here. Take a look at the cleanliness. Also, notice Dodo Mat have just delivered me a huge amount of insulation. Somebody hammered me in a video for saying insulation for the new van build, which is going to be launching in a couple of weeks. So we are installing today the StarV mounts. Very excited about this. Sometimes the simplest solutions are the best, and this to me was hands down the best mount I could see on the internet. Total transparency. I do like to let you know when we work with businesses. StarV mount have sent us this. I contacted them. They haven't contacted me. They're not paying me. I got in touch with them because to me this was the best product on the market for what I wanted. Fully marine grade stainless steel and powder coated. It clamps the Starlink in. I'll show you how to fit it in a second. It comes with security bolts so that you can't get in there easily. It's got loads of mounting options. You can mount it directly to your van roof, or like I'm gonna do, I'm gonna mount it to my roof rack today. We've also got a couple of Zeb nuts to go into my Uni-Strut on the roof. Switch relay to power the 12 volt to 48 volt device. Essentially, this steps the power up from 12 volt to 48 volt. By installing this, you're gonna get a much more consistent and reliable internet. Nice little remote switch so we can have a switch for the Starlink. These are the security bolts. And then I've also got this, which is a Scanstrut roof mount so that you can use the factory cable from Starlink. So by the end of this video, Starlink is gonna be mounted on the roof. We're gonna have the Scanstrut fitted, the switch fitted, 12 volt fitted, and this beauty fitted. If you want to get yourself a discount on StarV mount products, I'm going to put a link and a discount code in the description so you can grab yourself 10% off. So this is our mount. Loads of mounting holes on the back. You can also mount it flat or on a slight angle because there's mounting holes there. Two parts. The thing is with your Starlink is they're worth a couple hundred quid. So you don't want something that's worth a couple of hundred quid on your roof in a mount that can easily be nicked. It's got some nice foam packers in there so it won't damage the Starlink. Thread the factory cable through there. Plug that in. That then slides onto there. Fit the larger piece onto your Starlink and then the smaller piece. These security bolts have a specific tool required to open them. Take a washer. All comes with the kit. That one goes in there. Security bolt two, washer. That's how easy it is to fit to your Starlink. Now I'm gonna take this off, fit it to the roof. Back on the roof, windy. Because I've got Unistrut as part of my roof rack, I'm just gonna be using some Zeb nuts, bolt it to the roof. You can mount it to your roof flat if you want to. Zeb nuts easy. They just twist in there like that. Boom. One, two. StarV mount goes straight on there. Comes with some stainless steel bolts. Penny washer, spring washer, because we don't want this flying off at 60 mile an hour on the motorway. Don't look too closely at my solar panels, because one, they need a clean, and two, my penny washers that I thought were stainless steel weren't stainless steel. Cable in. Oh, look at it. I haven't thought this fully through, because now I need to get that on there. I'm gonna have to whip this solar panel off, aren't I? Removing solar panel. Security bolts. She's on. Look at it. What a beast. What a beast. That is not going anywhere. Nice and secure. Security bolts, so nobody with a cheeky 6mm Allen key or whatever it is thinks they can get it off. First problem fixed. Mounting it to the roof. Done. Next problem, getting the cable through the roof. So I've taken this solar panel off here. I'm thinking I'm gonna bring that cable gland so I can use the original cable through either here or here. So we need to dip inside, take down some moon boxes, take down some of the L track, and then we can get to this area, which is why I built my van using the L track, so that everything is removable and you can get to and you can modify your van. By the way, this has not leaked one bit. Nothing has leaked. We're a full year of all this stuff being on the van. That's gone quick, hasn't it? Back in the van. So we need to remove this panel here. I was just trying to take that moon box down and I realized there's a light strip bolted to it like an idiot. What is going on with this? Not only did I bolt that light strip on, I also double-sided sticky taped it on like a... Why? Oh, it's so tightly fixed on there. What a bend. Come on. Yes! Access granted. We're off. Slightly harder than I thought it was going to be that, but I was trying to remove as little pieces as possible. But that's where we're coming through, somewhere around here. Roof lining problem solved. We now need to get our cable through the van. We're using this Scanstrut gland. This one allows you to just use the original cable because it's got quite a big pass-through hole, and then a big rubber bung goes in there. Back on the roof. Here is where we're going to come through. This is the little grommet it comes with. Little clean. Mask up the area. Good spot there. Draw around this. Pencil drawn, marked out. I've leveled up my game here because I've bought an actual center punch instead of using a nail. This just stops the drill bit from like wiggling around on the surface. 3mm drill bit going through. Oh, have you made me lunch? Yeah. Oh. Does the cable fit? That's what we've got to see. And that, oh, just needs a little bit more, doesn't it? Deburring tool. Get rid of that sharp edge. To deburr the little holes, just going in with little drill bit. I think that's about done. Yeah. Take this tape off. Got that face mask on. This stuff stinks. I am not using a wooden plate underneath and screwing it in. I'm using stainless steel bolts and nuts, M3, because I tried it last time I put a gland in, and I tried to use a little wooden plate underneath, and it just, the screws didn't really bite very well. So yeah, nuts and bolts all the way. Sticky grommet, or whatever that is, that's what does the waterproofing. Line it up real nice. That then goes on there. Penny washers, M3 nylock nuts. Could have done with a ginny here, guys. These little jobs, you always think, oh, I'll just do that. And before you know it, you're locked in for 4 hours. Little hack for you, because I'm on my own and I haven't got a ginny to help. Every time I try and put a washer or a nut on, these bolts are just pushing up. So, a little bit of tape over there like that. Boom, they are on. Then it is rubber grommet on there, plastic case on there. Line those up with the screw holes. Screw that on. Yes! Happy with that. Left a little bit of slack on here so I can just zip tie that. Done. Solar panel back on. YouTube magic. Done. Look at that. Solar panel on. I'm happy with that. Looks mint. Nice and secure. Cables through. Cable gland is covered by the solar panel to give it a bit more protection. I've even replaced my washers here because they were rusting. Let's get inside. Right, that cable is in. Pulled through there, through some conduit, out into where we're going to wire it up. I can stick all this back. 3, 2, 1. Done. Okay, this is back in. This is back in. That's back in. That's back in. Moon boxes are back in, so now we need to crack on with the wiring. I wouldn't have needed to put all that away, but I'm using the van this weekend. We've got a charity event that I help out with, and I'm marshalling in my van. I'm a feed station, so I needed to put the van back together for that tomorrow. So next time you see me, we'll be post-event, and we'll crack on and get these electrics finished. Back on the van. Next step, we need to install the DC mini link. This changes the power from 12 to 48 volts, which is prime for a Starlink mini. Comes with a relay, nice little switch on off, so I'll be able to turn the Starlink on and off nice and easily. StarV mount, provide a little diagram. Comes with a little adapter cable to suit the original Starlink cable that's provided. This just wires into the mini power link. Before we can put that wiring in, I need to strip out all of this again. Done. Right, up here we have got the old cigarette lighter circuit, 2.5mm cable running back to my 12 volt fuse board. I've also got up here another set of USB ports. It's the way from toddler hands that like to smash everything. So what I'm thinking is, this is one of those jobs I just haven't got to yet. Little piece of wood along here. Does it fit?
No, it doesn't.
Test fit number 2. Okay, that's better. Test fit number 4. There we go. Oh. We're in. Oh, we're a little out. What I should have done here is make a template. Test fit number 5. Right, that is in. Right, I've just run the route around it to smooth it all out. Gonna have StarV mount switch there, and then USB sockets underneath. Switch is mounted there. C-line switch is going in there. I just need to order a surround for that. On the back, we've got the DC mini kit. Relay here. Switch is wired to relay. Relay is wired to the StarV mini link. I've wired in the port to attach the original Starlink cable to. And then this just needs to wire into my 2.5mm cable that's already in the van. I'm just using these heat shrink connectors. These are brilliant. I'll put a link in the description to connect together my power cables. Just crimp them on and then heat them up. Last two wires to crimp. That and slides back into there. I've ordered a new cover for that because it doesn't fit, but that will be properly put on. So hopefully, I'll put the fuse back in a second and we'll test it. Fuse is back in, let's test. USB socket, is that working? Yes. And then it's just a case of seeing if our Starlink works. Turn it on, do we get a blue light? Ooh, blue light. That means I should be able to pick up the Starlink on the phone now. Connecting. Boom. Yes. Nice. Well happy with that. I can't tell you how much I hated our previous setup. Right, whilst that is booting itself up, I'm gonna stick this panel back on here. 3, 2, 1. Yes, look at it. We've got pretty good coverage so far. Initial review, super easy to install. All the electric stuff comes with a circuit diagram. It's literally plug and play. You've just got to wire a few bits together. It's all labeled, all the wires are labeled. There's color-coded diagrams, it's bang on. The actual StarV mount, stainless steel, marine grade, made in Britain. It's a quality bit of kit. It's holding it nice and secure. It's got those security bolts in as well, so it's not gonna get tampered with. It's not gonna get taken by anyone. It's a lot of money, that Starlink dish, and it's a much better solution than our previous setup where we had it on the dash. So happy days. I look forward to testing this on our next big adventure properly, but I'm pretty confident this is the way to go. Don't forget, there'll be a link in the description and a discount code to grab yourself some discount off StarV mount. Click here to see one of my other build videos. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.